Hello everyone. Today I'll be sharing with you our last camping trip in our new air tent by RBM Coody. Me and my wife decided to take a trip to North Georgia mountains on a cool weekend when temperatures was in the 30s at nighttime and only in 60s during daytime. To protect our tent, first we laid tarp on the ground and unrolled tent on top of it. Tent is pretty big and heavy, so I'll try to not lift up as more as I have to. This tent don't have any poles inside. It supports by air only. Tent got two valves on each side, which before pumping, I need to close at least one of them so air won't escape. After securing the valve and make sure it's tight, I moved to another valve, another side of the tent, and closed only one valve. Well, in this situation, I had to close it all valves tight and open top of it where I can put a hose to it to pump the air. And from previous camping, that was a little bit tight, but I had to manage with that. To connect the air hose from a pump, all you have to do is just plug in. It stays pretty tight. This air pump comes with a tent when you order it and got a gauge on it. When you have to pump the air, you have to pump it approximately to 7 psi. Even if this tent's so big, it took me only 5 minutes to get air in it by this air pump was being provided by the company. After pumping enough air to attend, all I had to do is disconnect this air hose from it and close that cap on a valve just to secure to air stay in it. To secure tent to the ground, I use screws which I purchased separately on Amazon. And I like them because it's much easier to take them out later when you're packing back your tent. Entry door and all windows got roll up design. That's what I did so I can unload my camping gear. Don't have to move around. Our tent got four windows, two on each side, and also two entrances, one main one and one on the back. And also it's got an option for the wood stove, which we don't have. Back room got two windows on top, which closed by material, but you cannot be opened because it's just a plastic. So that's how a tent looks inside before we're unloading our stuff. We brought water-resistant carpet with us for the front room, just in case there's any water. A table, organizer for the stuff, air mattress, and all kind of electrical extension cords, little tables, you name it. We glamping, that's why we brought all kind of camping stuff, chairs, and which you'll see it later in the video after I set up. This right here, see, it's an AC/DC cooler, refrigerator, air mattress, which is a king size air mattress, which is very, very comfortable. And after we set up, that's how it looked like inside a tent. Cooler, refrigerator. We had a two heaters, electric heaters, as my wife's makeup table, another table by other side, two camping chairs. Like I mentioned before, it's a king size air mattress, and you see how much room inside the tent, even if we used that huge air mattress. This is our second camping trip in this tent, and to be honest with you, we are very happy with that. It's roomy, warm. In the winter time, we're probably going to be enjoying also that tent. But in the fall, right now, we're not using wood stove, but we're using just regular electric heaters. So we like it. And thank you for watching it. Hope you come back again and when I post next videos about this tent, when we're going to camp again.